Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy.
In this video, we will discuss about the anatomical differences between the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. But before, it would be just a brief overview, and for each division, we have uploaded videos. So if you are new here, for more understanding, watch it later. So, to our topic, the sympathetic nervous system is otherwise known as the fight or flight response, because this division prepares us for stressful and emergency situations, as well as for exercise. In contrast, the parasympathetic nervous system is known as the rest and digest response, as this division prepares us to conserve energy and predominate sympathetic activities when we are eating or in resting state. In addition, the sympathetic division is also known as thoracolumbar outflow, while the parasympathetic division is called the craniosacral outflow. For this, here I'm drawing the brainstem and spinal cord. This is thalamus, part of the forebrain, and this is the brainstem, which I colored with green. Here, it is the spinal cord, which I colored with yellow. And this is the thoracic segment. This is the lumbar. And this is the sacral segment of spinal cord. The sympathetic division is called thoracolumbar outflow because the free ganglionic fibers of this system arise from this thoracic and from lumbar regions of the spinal cord, while the parasympathetic nervous system is known as the craniosacral outflow because the free ganglionic fibers of this system arise from this region of the brain, which is the brain stem, and other fibers of this division arise from sacral region of the spinal cord. Moreover, the free ganglionic fibers of the sympathetic division are short, and the forced ganglionic fibers are long, while in case of parasympathetic division, the free ganglionic fibers are long and the forced ganglionic fibers are short. The free ganglionic neurons of both divisions are cholinergic, mean they secrete acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter. So here, in case of parasympathetic nervous system, the neurotransmitter is acetylcholine. While same here, in the ganglia between the postganglionic and the effector organs, for example the stomach here, the neurotransmitter is again acetylcholine. Similarly, in case of sympathetic nervous system, in first ganglia, we have the neurotransmitter acetylcholine as a signaling molecule, but without a few exceptions, all the first ganglionic neurons of sympathetic division innervating the target organs, for example the heart here, secrete noradrenaline as a neurotransmitter. Besides, the sympathetic ganglia are usually close to the spinal cord, and so the free ganglionic fibers are short. Whereas the ganglia of parasympathetic division are close to the organ innervated, and that's why the free ganglionic fibers are long. In addition, the sympathetic fibers extensively give rise to branches and stimulate many ganglia at once by a single nerve fiber. While in case of parasympathetic fibers, there is no branching except the vagus nerve, which innervate most of the thoracoabdominal organs. Moreover, the sympathetic fiber terminals make contact with a large number of first ganglionic neurons. In some ganglia, the ratio of free ganglionic axons to first ganglionic neurons may be 1:20 or more. The parasympathetic system, in contrast, mostly have 1-to-1 relationship between the number of free ganglionic and first ganglionic fibers. And that's why the sympathetic organization permits a diffuse discharge by innervating many organs by a single fiber, while the parasympathetic division mostly innervate every organ by separate neurons which do not overlap with other neurons, which result in discrete response of this division. In addition to it, the sympathetic system is distributed to effectors throughout the body, innervating practically all effector systems in the body, whereas the parasympathetic distribution is much more limited. Furthermore, the widespread effect of the sympathetic nervous system is also due to the secretion of adrenaline and noradrenaline from the adrenal gland. In response, these hormones target all sympathetic receptors in the peripheral nervous system. In contrast, the parasympathetic nervous system does not have any gland that may secrete parasympathomimetic agents like acetylcholine. In it lost, remember that there may be some exception, and that's why these distinctions between the two systems do not apply to all sites. For more detail on these two divisions, please check out our videos on the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. And with this, thanks for watching and support us by subscribing to our channel.